Let's go to Margaret now. Morning, Margaret.
Morning.
Thank you for calling in, Margaret. You've got quite a tough one here about the potentially having children or not.
Yes. So 2 weeks ago, I was informed that I'd never be able to conceive naturally.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And ever since then, I've just been really struggling with communicating with my partner about it. I feel as if I'm just pushing him away from the situation because I feel so guilty. And I just don't really know how to deal with it all.
I don't know. It's a very, very distressing discovery. And how has he reacted to the news?
I mean, he's been as supportive as he can be, and I think he puts on quite a lot of a front for me, to support me. I mean, he hasn't really expressed many feelings about it because he's been more concerned about how I've reacted to it and looking after me in the situation.
Well, that's really good and is very... obviously, it's a lot to have to cope with. There probably will be ways you can be helped, which you can explore later. I know initially discovering you can't conceive naturally, it is a devastating discovery. But do try to confide in him. Let him comfort you. There is nothing to feel guilty about. You know, this is just one of those things. Difficult things happen to the loveliest people. You know, it isn't your responsibility. It is one of those things. Talk together, initially just to deal with the feelings, because they're difficult enough. But then later you can actually look at ways that if you do both want to have children, look at ways you could be helped. There's also, I mean, there's a very good organisation called Fertility Network, Fertility Network UK. They're on our website. They also, there's a part of them which is called More to Life, which is for couples who are involuntarily childless. So do use their support, you know, because you'll talk there to people who've been through the same journey as you, and they really will be able to help. But please, you know, let him cuddle you, let him comfort you, and then go back and talk to the doctors again about how you can be helped.
I hope that can help, Margaret. Thank you for phoning in.